spent the day listening to the light. We can call it listening to the light. The light of truth is so paradoxical. We're not used to it. But the more we get used to it, the better off we are. And so it's just important just to listen to it. You don't have to get it, per se. Get used to it, though. Getting used to it is getting it, almost. Until we realize there's nothing to get, there's nothing we need to get. For instance, the light says, I am God. I am God. There's only God. Why is the world so averse to anyone saying, I am God? Because God is what? Everywhereness. Everywhereness is where? Everywhere. Okay, so there's only everywhereness. The reason why people don't like it is it will bring to light the fact that everyone here is trying to be greater than God. That's why. Everything that the world disagrees with is because it will bring to light the fact they're trying to be greater than everywhere. They're trying to be the everywhereness, and the everywhereness be a location within their new everywhereness. For example, a breakthrough. There is no breakthrough. The breakthrough is to realize no breakthrough is needed. There is no breakthrough. There is no leap into reality. Realize there isn't any leap at all. Everyone's already here. Everyone's already in everywhereness. There's no enlightenment. There's just giving up the attempt at enlightenment, actually. We're trying to... What needs to be enlightened? Does everywhereness need to be enlightened? No. So the attempt at enlightenment is really what we call quote-unquote enlightenment is actually the giving up of the attempt to be enlightened, to be greater than God. Giving that up. Letting go of it. What the real goal is to just let go of all our attempts. All our attempts. The reason why we don't see the light is we're attempting to be greater than the light. The reason why we don't see God is we're attempting to be greater than God. The reason why we don't see ourself, our experience ourself, is because we're trying to be greater than ourself. We cannot know ourself. We can only be ourself. So all this talk is from the light, the one light. And I've just been listening to it and saying, wow. In a dialogue, like in my mind, it keeps bringing this up, saying, hey, look at this, look at this, look at this. And I just say, yeah, that's really great. So nobody does ask to do anything. All of this activity is an attempt to be greater than God, to be more than everywhere. It's an attempt to objectify everywhereness and say that we're not, everywhereness is in us, but we're not in everywhereness, you see. It's to say that we're greater. So we all just ignore it. We ignore the fact that everything's already here. Everything's already here. So there's nothing we have to do whatsoever except stop ignoring this. There's no accomplishment that needs to take place whatsoever, none. Everything, we're already here. Is everywhereness need an accomplishment to be what it is? No, it already is what it is. Everything is already is what it is. We don't need to put anything together, don't need to package anything, don't need to do anything. So what we're headed towards is just a simple acceptance of what is. Instead of trying to change what is. Now, we get confused because as we try to be greater than God, we automatically bring up the duality of less than God. You see, where there is no such duality in reality. There only God is, that's it. You can't be greater, there's no lesser. Everywhereness is everywhere. There's no greater everywhereness. There's no lesser everywhereness. There's no greater pure spaciousness. There's no lesser pure spaciousness. But as soon as we try, our desire is to be greater than God, then automatically lesser than God becomes this boogeyman, and we enter into dualistic judgment of what is greater and what is lesser, and we become all embroiled in conflicts and confusion. And so we think, no, we're just trying to heal this confusion. But there's no confusion, actually. Just drop the duality. Just drop the effort, the desire to be greater than God. It's not a need, it's a desire. And then drop the desire to be greater. The lesser goes with that. Two sides of one coin. But people don't see that here. They keep thinking, no, I'm just trying to make things better here. But it's really based on judgment of, I'm just trying to be better than reality. And so I'm fighting against the demons that seem to be lesser than reality. And I think I'm engaged with that, and that's more important than dropping the duality. So as long as we are good and evil are fighting, we're not aware that good and evil only arise from our desire to be greater than God. So the cure is to drop that desire and realize that everything is perfect. The desire to be greater implies that the category of lesser, right? More implies less. You can't have a concept of more unless you also have the concept of less. Concepts are inherently dualistic this way. Reality is not a concept. So as we just listen to the light talk to us, the light says to me, look, if you want to come and you want to listen, you want to talk, you want to hear what I have to say, fine, great. If not, I'm waiting. I'll wait for you. When you're ready, I'll be here to talk with you. That's it. That's all the light says. When you're ready, I'll be here. So what we do is we simply listen. We simply listen. That's all. We're simply overlooking the fact that everything is already perfectly abiding in pure spaciousness. There are no exceptions. As soon as we bring in greater abidance, we bring in lesser abidance. As soon as we say, well, it's possible to be greater than perfect inclusion, we bring in the concept, of the dualistic concept, well, it's possible to have lesser than greater inclusion. And then that, now, what do we do to... What we do is we have made bodies and identify what are bodies but perceptual mechanisms, perceiving. Perception gives this impression of more and less, a dualistic impression to us. So it simply validates our desire is what it does. Perception automatically gives greater weight to what is closer and clearer than what is farther away and less clear. And automatically we feel what is in the distance is fuzzy, ill-defined. We automatically feel that is less included in pure spaciousness, less than what is close, our hands, you know, stuff is close to us right here. We feel, oh, okay, I can see that this is, it seems more real to me than what is distant. Certain things are stronger flavors. It's contrast and difference is what sensory perception brings to us. And so it seems to validate our desires. Saying, oh, I see it is. There is greater and lesser. So we seem to be dwelling in the kingdom of greater and lesser. Like we're the new God, the new gods here, dwelling in this kingdom of greater and lesser. But all the while, this is an illusion, it's a mirage. Let's say we were not perceiving at all, but isn't this tree there in your yard, a tree over halfway around the world right now, oceans here, oceans there, water here, light there, isn't everything all dwelling in the now of perfect spaciousness right now? Isn't everywhereness everywhere right now? It doesn't need our the body perception to chime in any way for that to be so. If we close our eyes, does it stop being that way? If we close our eyes, does our body stop being dwelling in everywhereness? We think that if we close our eyes, somehow we're depriving everything of being known. But isn't it already known to everywhereness? Isn't it already in everywhereness? Isn't everywhereness already everywhere? So how does not saying we're not experiencing it, how does that change that fact? Does anything need to be experienced to be perfectly included? Do we need to give our attention to perception? What is perception? Does perception ever show us the truth? Does it ever remind us of truth? We may have to have this spiritual vision that use our will, say, no, this is what's true. Perception is not true. It's not telling us the truth. Perception can still be there. We just know it's a liar. That's all. Just don't believe what's telling you. The body can still be there, but you do not accept anything it has to say. You know, it's just a born liar, actually. Sensory perception is a born liar. It's designed as a liar by design. So we do not need to be real keen and acute and catch this, catch that. You know, don't need to be into our bodies like that at all. The body is not going to tell us anything about truth. It'll just tell us about pleasure and pain, but that has nothing to do with the facts of reality. So the light talks to us when we say, "Hey, light, talk to me." Okay, the light will talk to us, and it'll seem paradoxical to be enlightened, give up enlightenment, stop trying to be enlightened. Because if you're trying to be enlightened, you're not recognizing that everything is already enlightened. Everything is already perfectly included. There's no ignorance anywhere, actually. People say we're trying to get rid of ignorance. There isn't any ignorance. Trying to get rid of suffering. There isn't really any suffering. That's all relative. It's all relative. It's all in the realm of illusion, mirage, delusion. It's all in the mind, when the mind tries to be relative, more and less. And I believe that at some point we can just accept. We don't need to do anything. We don't need to do anything. To know, to realize truth, to accept truth, to experience truth, or to be truth, we don't need to do anything. To be true, everything already is true. Everything already is true. Everywhere already is truth. There's only truth. There's only light. Everything already is light. So the real thing is just simply to stop trying to overlook this fact. It's not that we need to establish the fact at all. The more we try to establish it, the blinder we are. There's nothing that has to be established. It's likened to a dream because in a dream we're completely overlooking the actual facts of what's happening to us, where we are entirely, right? It's like that. We're completely overlooking the fact that everything, there's only total abidance of everywhere abiding in everywhere. And this realization is just a natural realization. We're trying not to realize, is what we're really trying to do. We're trying not to realize this. So realization is just to give up trying so hard not to realize. Enlightenment is just give up trying so hard not to be enlightened. Not to realize. Which is, we try and practice a mood of repentance, patience, and just try to not, just listen. Don't try to do anything, don't try to grasp anything. There's nothing to grasp. There's no leaping. You cannot leap into reality, because that implies there's some place other than reality that you're leaping from. You can't jump into reality. We're already there. There's no way we can make a breakthrough into reality. We're already in reality. But we're in this fantasy of, like, how do I jump? How do I make the leap? Well, then you're also fantasizing that you must be someplace that's not in reality right now, that you're leaping from, and then your attention is on. But where is this? Where am I now? This other place that I'm leaping from? Wow, this is too scary. I'm not able to get the will to make the leap, and then you start trying to work with this other place that, but it's all a dream. The fact is, we don't need to make any sort of leap. We're already here, inescapably, unavoidably here. We're unavoidably here, inescapably. We can't arrive here. Arrive from where? There's no paths to take. Paths from where? Someplace outside of everywhereness? There's some path that leads you into everywhereness. We need to give up the belief that a path is necessary, that we're on some path to getting somewhere. There's nowhere to get in everywhereness. Does everywhereness have a place we have to get to? Say, okay, now I'm in everywhereness. Before I wasn't. False impression. So I hope the light just keeps talking. I love it. Love to listen to the lights. Music to my ears. The world is full of this rush towards breakthroughs. We're going to have a breakthrough. Now, I say I have breakthroughs. What I really mean is I'm realizing no breakthroughs are necessary. More than that, no breakthroughs are even possible. If we think we need a breakthrough, doesn't that automatically cause a wall to arise? Say, oh, I need a breakthrough. Oh, there's the wall. I need to break through that wall. But isn't the wall also in pure spaciousness? Isn't that everywhereness also? So when we get through the wall, are we going to find on the other side everywhereness? Isn't everywhereness on both sides of the wall? And also the wall too? Isn't it all just one seamless oneness? So where do we need to get to find oneness? We're trying to, our effort to find oneness is what blinds us to it. It's our seeking that keeps us from realizing the truth. It's our seeking for truth that is the very defense against it, actually. But paradoxically, the spiritual path is winding down the seeking. It is realizing it's not a need, it's a desire. Because when we make it into a need, believe it's a need, then the whole thing becomes heavy. Very frightful and heavy. But if we see it as simply a desire, a silly desire, a little silly game we wanted to play, then we can drop the seeking. We don't need to seek. Seeking is just a way of saying that reality isn't real. It's not the real reality. We're seeking another one. An object. Objectifying it. So I'm sure many have heard all this before in one way or the other, but we keep focusing on, keep listening to the light, keep listening to the light. What is that? It sounds better and better and better, and you say, yeah, 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 yeah. Now, you can't get close to truth because you're already in truth. How can you get close to it? So you have to give up this idea of closer and farther away. There isn't any distance to everywhereness. Everywhereness is not measurable. It's immediate, right? It's immediate. All is immediate. And it doesn't require realization to be what it is. So you might say, you know, non-realization is the answer, so to speak. Pure, total non-realization is nothing can be realized. Who's the realizer? Everything is free of realization. Everything is free of enlightenment. Perfect non-enlightenment, actually. Perfect non-realization is a better way to say it, actually. The way to say it is through negation, the negative. It's not this, it's not, it's perfect non-realization. We keep believing everything needs something. No, perfect non-need. So as much as possible, we listen to the light, the talk of the light. a little more light clarity came to light as I was walking inside to reemphasize, like I was thinking about sickness and healing. But did you know, where does sickness come from? Sickness came from the desire to heal. Okay, the desire to heal. Where else could sickness come from? There's no sickness. There's nothing sick with everywhereness. How could everywhereness be sick? So, it's our desire to be greater than God, to improve upon, that means there's something lesser that we need to, if we want to heal something, don't we have to have sickness, seem to have sickness? So it's always the positive we need that brings about the negative. Not the negative that brings about the positive. It's the positive that brings, you say, I want to heal. I want to heal. I want to jump into reality. Oh, there has to be a place that's negative, not non-reality. Oh, I want to heal. Oh, there must be something that's sick then. So it's our desire to be more than God, better than God, that brings in this hellish realm. Like, I want to be more than the light. Oh my gosh, what is that darkness? I see darkness. Oh, this is what I want to get free of. You know, oh, I need to get free of this darkness. Oh, I want to heal. Oh, here's a sickness. Then we think, okay, good. I gotta get rid of this sickness. To get rid of sickness, give up trying to heal. To get rid of darkness, give up trying to be more than the light. To give up hell, give up trying to be more than heaven, better than heaven. To give up misery, give up trying to be more than happy. But of course we're deluded. We think, the problem isn't I'm trying to heal. The problem is that there's a sickness there. But we don't see that it's our desire to heal that's causing the sickness. So the more we keep healing sickness, the more sickness keeps appearing. The more our desire is to heal, the more sickness arises. If we really want to drop sickness, drop the desire to heal sickness. Sickness is not causing itself. It's the flip side of the desire to heal. And the desire to heal is a way to bear witness to believe that something's wrong with reality. Otherwise, why would we want to heal something? How could the idea I need to heal be present in perfection? It's not possible. So it's only our desire that perfection not be perfect, you see. Or that we want it to be more perfect, which is a way to say it's not perfect, really. That desire, I want to be more perfect, brings a feeling of less perfect, you see. And then think, okay, we just need to fix this less perfect. We objectify it then as if we are better. And, you know, the healthy are better than the sick, and we're helping the sick. This whole dichotomy, dualistic dichotomy arises this way. So listen to the light, wherever you can hear the light talking to you. Keep listening. And it will say stuff that you don't expect to hear. And it's just like opposite of what you're used to. You know, just like, wow. To get rid of all these problems, stop trying to improve everything. How can we improve upon everywhereness? Is there something that needs to be improved upon? Actually, is our actual being need to be improved? If we don't believe it needs to be improved, we will see, you know, that which needs to be improved. We'll say, oh my gosh, look at all this stuff. It was terrible. I need to improve so much here. So much I need to improve. No end to it. But then drop the desire to improve, and you'll see that everything's already completely, being is totally perfect. There's absolutely no need to improve. It was always only a desire. You see, we are running on desire. Not need. No such thing as need in reality. It's desire. We desire to be greater than God. So we honor our creativity in trying to show us, you know, that's possible. But we have this dualistic dream is all we end up with, and think we're playing God. You know, we're playing God. We think we're playing God or something different. We think we're different than God. Think we're somewhere else other than in God, as God. We think we're something somehow separate and different, etc. Even though we're not. But we keep being distracted. Okay, so again, to be free of sickness, give up the desire to heal. Consider that. All right, that's it.